People have been saying that this new Pixel 10 is going all in. Others say it's just the same again and again. Today I step in and begin to see if the 10 is a win-win, or if Google is just acting. This phone is Moonstone, a shade of blue only your dogs have known. Google wants to dethrone the one and only iPhone, except it costs 1,000 bones, so you gotta get a bank loan. Tim Cook's out in his lawn chair, completely unaware of Google's 4% market share. But today we'll play fair. First, I should declare that headphone users, beware. Now, most people wouldn't be able to tell the difference between the Pixel 9 Pro and the Pixel 10 Pro, even if it hit them in the face while doom-scrolling in bed at night. However, if you happen to have your own personal magnetic field viewing film handy, you know, the one with the nickel flakes suspended in a colloidal solution, you can clearly tell that the Pixel 10 Pro XL has a new magnetical ring around the back wireless charger. This is to better attach wireless charging accessories with, and I'm a huge fan. Obviously, these are very well hidden on the inside, and nobody besides Clark Kent can tell which phone you're repping from the outside, which is a real bummer if Google's trying to attract iPhone users, because that's kind of like their main thing. Working our way up through the Mohs scale of hardness, we see that again Google is not using plastic, which would scratch at a level 2 or 3, or sapphire, which would scratch at a level 8 or 9. Google's using Gorilla Glass Victus 2, which scratches at a level 6, with deeper grooves at a level 7. Everything is pretty normal so far. However, since the Pixel 10 Pro gets a whopping 7 years worth of software updates, insinuating a long useful lifespan, I would recommend adding some exterior protection to that glass. This is Prism 2.0 from my channel sponsor Dbrand. It only costs a few extra bucks and takes a few seconds to install, yet adds a monumental amount of peace of mind. And we all know having one less thing to worry about is pretty priceless these days. Glass is glass, and you want the replaceable layer to shatter before your $1,000 smartphone does. And it also comes with two in a box. Where was I? Oh yeah. The upper hole punch camera is a 48 megapixel sensor. It sits right below the earpiece slit that is exactly the same width as a single razor blade. No speaker grills to get dirty or fall out up here. Google has, however, added some rather large mesh grates over the lower loudspeaker and microphone hole openings. These are surprisingly secure though, and won't be falling out on their own. However, if you do happen to set your phone down in mud, dirt, or jello, there's a good chance these might get dirty, with no way of cleaning them out easily, so watch out for that. They do look good though. I do prefer the rugged chainmail vibe over the mirror finished aluminum. Scratches and scuffs are gonna show up a lot easier on a polished surface, but at least the buttons are made from metal. They are also removable, similar to Samsung's design. You can easily swap buttons with your friends, or just lose them indefinitely. The volume rocker does have a secret number etched on the inside of the hole, but that number does not appear to be correlated with my serial, SKU, or IMEI. The buttons are secure enough, though, that they won't ever fall out on their own. The top of our glossy Moonstone phone has more of the 100% recycled aluminum frame, a noise-canceling microphone hole, and our SIM card tray, which does not include an expandable storage SD card slot. It does have a gray rubber ring for the IP68 water resistance rating, and my IMEI is etched on the inside for the whole world to see. Please don't steal my identity. The left side of the phone has some antenna lines, and the bottom, again, has those two large grills, another antenna line, and our 45-watt USB-C 3.2 port, same as the Samsung Galaxy S25 Ultra. The iPhone 16 Pro Max only taps out at 30 watts, but who's counting? Google calls this a silky matte glass back, and it does feel good. The highly glossy and shiny G on the back, however, is not included in the glass edge. You can see that the sticker or shielding that they put over the G spot is not quite consistent with the front of the G underneath. It doesn't quite line up. But if you're zoomed in this far to nitpick the branding on the backside of a phone, you're either over 80 or an iPhone user. So let's move up to the camera shelf. Google says this thing is diamond cut, which either refers to the polishing of the metal or the process used to refine the edge of the glass lens that covers the three cameras. Polishing the edge makes sure light doesn't refract inside the glass while taking pictures. the 48 megapixel wide angle, 50 megapixel normal camera, and 48 megapixel 5x telephoto are all covered with the same piece of glass. The flash is a plastic diffused single LED that sits on top of what I think is the thermometer thing. Not really sure. Turning up the heat a bit, the 6.8 inch 120Hz 3300 nit display lasted 20 seconds before getting no damage. The oleophobic coating does evaporate though, so don't try this at home. We have again been given an ultrasonic fingerprint scanner under the glass, which if you've been around a while, you know that fingerprint scanners don't often work for me. However, even with some additional level 7 deeper grooves lacerated all over the ultrasonic area, the scanner still reads and unlocks my phone every single time. Nice work, Google. Thumbs up for that. Finally, the bin test. Structural integrity matters quite a whole lot when you want your phone to last the entire 7 years worth of updates, and if you're subscribed here, you're probably the type of person who wants the hardware to last as long as the software. And Google does not disappoint. This Pixel 10 Pro XL might just be their strongest phone yet. Even though it's the largest variant of the Pixel 10 lineup, the Pro XL has no flex, no creaks, no groans, and no cracks when bent from the front or the back. While I'm personally disappointed we didn't get to immediately see the insides, I am happy that the Pixel Pro XL passes my durability test. Plus, with just a small snap of my fingers, we can preview what the teardown is going to look like with my teardown skin. Just don't look at the bottom left corner yet, because it looks like Google has massively improved the battery removal process. Spoiler alert. The never-yellowing transparent D-brand Ghost case allows your teardown skin to still shine through, making you the coolest person in a 3,963.19-mile radius, complete with magnets. Bundle the Ghost case and the Prism screen protector and get 42% off the glass. Use code JERRYRIG. Link is down in the description. I'll see you in the teardown. Thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.